it's a very difficult thing to deal with mentally. You know, I mean, it's hard to look up and say, oh, you're gubbed, the game's over. You might as well pack it in, you know. And I don't think, I mean, a lot of people retire gracefully, but I think, like in my case, and a lot of people's cases, it's hard to cope with when you know that you can't do it anymore. It's difficult. I mean, even now, I mean, I watch some of the games and you think, I should have been playing there now.
Heaven bent to take my hand and lead me through the fire, be the long-awaited answer to a long and painful fight. Truth be told, I've tried my best, but somewhere along the way I got caught up in all there was to offer. But the cost was so much more than I could bear. Though I've tried,
if I'm speaking honest about hearing Ralph's story, it was frustrating as a football fan to hear him talk about maybe his personal problems and that, when you know what he was capable of on a football field. And at the back of it all, I had to stay detached from his own story, but on a personal level, I just wish he had given himself a shake sometimes and just say, Ralph, knuckle down, you've got the world at your feet here.
It was like a football and culture. You know, after every game, you get your shower, shave, get out of the dressing room, go for a drink with your teammates and have a drink, and that was it, and then party on. And it was just, in my time, that's just the way it was. I mean, it's totally different now. I've cut it down. I'm down to 14 a day, man. I'm only joking. No, people get the wrong perception with the press, you know. They've got you billed as an alcoholic, blah, blah, blah. I like a drink, but I don't have to get up in the morning and go straight to the fridge. I mean, I could go without it for days, if you like, you know. So I do like a drink, but there's no way I'm an alcoholic.